Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play the Master Levels of Doom 2. I'm Ultima Mantoid, and I'm just gonna get started. This is the Black Tower by Cranium. I don't want to play this map anymore. I will explain why. Okay, I'm going to try and save as much of my shotgun ammo as I can. So I'm going to ignore most of the enemies here. This bottom floor is divided into four sections. That's the western quadrant. That's the north. That's the east. And that's the south. The way you can tell where you're at is that the soul sphere is between the west and the north, and there is nothing between north and east. So, run for the rocket launcher. Make sure you pick up the chain gun. That's important. And you do want to kill the shotgunners. That is also important. There we go. Let's rip shotgun. We'll go to the east section next. Ignore the Cacodemon. Alright, gonna just pick these guys off carefully. Make sure you grab the backpack, press the switch, grab all the rockets that you can. Alright. Just press this and go upstairs. Yes, I blocked the southern section off, but we will be back later, you'll understand. This step right here is bugged, the one literally in front of me, that turns solid black. Enemies fall through it for some reason. Press that switch, and it raises that up. Yet, for some reason, Doom Guy can't fall through it, but enemies can. Not sure how that works. And enemies that are bigger than Doom Guy fall through it. Wait for the click. Press the button. It just lowers it back down so you can get to it. There's another way up there besides, you know, running all the way up the stairs. You can wait for the soul sphere to get to a certain height, jump down on the platform, ride it to the top, and then jump up there. But I prefer this method. Okay, what we're gonna do is we're going to leave the Barons alone. We're going to leave the Barons alone. Or so I thought. That's what we were going to do. Run in and just start clearing out specters. You can use the insides as a hiding spot, but it's not the safest. You want to be very quick about doing this. If you want to fire a BFG shot through here, you're more than welcome to. But your main goal is to clear out the specters and the chain gunners so that they don't kill you. Now, you want to keep an eye on the eastern and western windows. Okay, alright, we got that. Ignore the arch file. Okay, try and ignore this guy too. Except that's just not going to be possible. He wants to be in the way. Okay, that Cacodemon up there. You want to try and get him. See how the background ate my rocket? Now, come on. It's over here. I believe that's all of them. Now we gotta watch the other side. By the way, the north entrance is right here, so that's your compass. You walk out the northern side. Okay, I'm gonna just stand right here for a moment. because I'm tired of this. Okay, alright, we're gonna go ahead and kill the archvile. Alright. Archvile's dead. We do have enemies out there that are not awake. So what I'm going to try and do is I'm gonna lower this. Quickly run up here. Hey buddy, fuck off. I didn't invite you to tea time. Especially not with Alan Rickman there. Okay. That's... Oh! Okay. Alright, there's another way we can do this. I'm gonna go ahead and start clearing these guys out. We're gonna just start clearing out here. Energy cell pack, back wall. You gotta run all the way around to the right, but it gives you the plasma gun. All these switches, by the way, you do need to press. Let's see, I gotta remember what... Okay, yeah, there it is. Have your BFG ready. Step inside. Press this wall, but have the shot already going. Because that guy's up there. Press that. Run around, get your chain gun ready. There's your secret. Step forward and run back. Now, if it worked, I will show you what... Okay, I just squished another guy. Alright. See if I can do it. Okay, it got eaten. I think we got them all. I'm going to check. We actually got all of the Cacodemons. Okay, let me explain here. You see these green arrows over here in this window to the right, over here. Those are dead Cacodemon bodies. This map has a particularly interesting bug, and I don't know how or why or what causes it, but the eastern window here and the western window over here, all the way over here, are bugged where the Cacodemons will either not wake up or not come out of the windows. So, or they don't even lift high enough to where they can come out the window, even if they do wake up. So, that's why focusing on the western and eastern windows is absolutely paramount. If you want to get, I mean, completely kill everything. This is the only way that you will kill everything. So now that that's done, let me disable that cheat so I cannot show that off. And we're gonna go back. Come on. There we go. Alright. You can use the chain gun through here. Feel free. This is one of those times I do advocate getting a partial invisibility, because it will help. It's okay. It's okay to have the chain gun. And it is okay to kill lost souls here. If you're playing in GZ Doom, you have to kill them anyway. Or any form of, Z-Doom port. Now that the outer hallway is opened up, you can start going through and, yeah. Using, or, what am I saying? English is hard. That's what I'm saying. There's two ways you can handle this. I'll show you the reckless method. It's so fun. I love it. It's so great. Obviously, that looks like a door, but you'd be wrong. Or are you? That switch behind the Baron, when you press it, you heard something open. So if you do come back here, you'll get night amplification and a plasma rifle. You know, as soon as I can find what it's called. I mean, it's not like it showed up on screen or anything. Also, this shows up. You do want to kind of hang on to some rockets. You don't want to waste all of them. Don't grab that armor. You'll see why here in just a moment. I do suggest using the super shotgun here, and don't let that close. If you can absolutely help it. Oh! That was great! Just keep wailing away like this. The reason I say that is because if you let the door squish any of the bodies, then he'll resurrect them as ghosts, and that is no bueno. That is not good. We're now on the next floor. Alright, we'll just... This is how I like picking these guys off in particular. Come around. There is... Yeah, you heard that. There are enemies in the floor on this floor. That sounds redundant, I realize, but... As soon as you step up on the first floor, the wall there will, around you will raise up. Do not step up on the second floor. If you want to grab the rockets, that's fine. My suggestion here, don't walk straight in front of the face, because there is a Baron right in front of it, in the floor. Just carefully walk up to it and use it, and then get ready. There we go. Two BFG shots should do it. Feel free to use more if you need to. There's plenty of super shotgun ammo on this floor, so feel free to use as much of it as you want or need. I mean, obviously don't go so ham that you run out. I mean, that would kind of defeat the whole purpose, right? I want those rockets, damn it! Give me rockets! Get up there. Press that switch, we'll lower to the yellow key. By the way, where all those chain gunners were, each one of them has a plasma cell. Make sure to pick those up. This is the yellow door. Don't forget that it's here. Yeah, that's a trapped door. There's a barrel in front of it inside. So it's like as soon as you go, it opens up and then you fire out of habit because you're like, oh, enemies! And it detonates in your face. It's kind of nice. This floor we're going to rush through as fast as possible. Get ready. It's not fun. Looks empty. I mean, there's a specter there. There's a specter there. Not too bad, right? We're going to run straight behind us. And press that switch. Now we're going to get ready with the BFG. It didn't kill him. Okay. Shit, that just took away some precious invulnerability time. Grab your rocket launcher and get in the face of these pain elementals. Quickly look for the Baron face while you still can. There's a switch in the very back of the room. Press it. I managed to press it through the Revenant. Run to the back of that. Press it. We'll open up another Revenant. Grab the armor and you will wake up the Cyber Demon, the king of the top floor. Now here's where you're going to want to run in a circle. Just pick off random imps. Make sure at 100% of all times that you know where your cyber demon's at. That corner is getting congested. See what I mean? He almost got me. You want him to infight with as much as possible. Just keep an eye out. Keep looking for imps around the edges. And try not to get cornered and trapped. Because that's the most guaranteed way you're going to die. Press that switch with all the shotgun ammo. Okay, we're good right now. It's narrowed out enough. There's a lot of mayhem going on here. Oh, I thought he got hit. You know what? Fuck it. There's only three cacos left. Might as well kill him. Oh, never mind. There's an arachnotron, too. Get him! Get him! And now the real fight begins. Oh, we still got a cacodemon out there. I prefer using the super shotgun in this fight. You're free to use whatever weapon you want. Alright, now, before you go anywhere else, look around outside, make sure that you've got all the dead cacos. This map is very awful for having enemies that fall off the edge. And this is why I said you want to, you know, it's advisable to use the super shotgun. I think everyone's dead, so now what you do is run up here, see where the yellow or the blue key is here. Press the switch, run all the way around, get your BFG ready. And just start firing. Your goal here is to kill all the pain elementals. First, anyway. And once you narrow them down some, you can just start picking off the barons. Alright, so, everyone's dead on this floor. The reason you want to press this switch is to just open up to go back down the tower. So, we were on the top floor, now we're going back down. And something cool here, there's plenty of plasma, so don't hesitate to spam it. This is going to be another floor that's flooded. But, this time, now you have to find your way back out, which is over here. Press that. Also, on every floor but the ground floor, feel free to use rockets. I would suggest having the BFG equipped as you go down every floor. Don't forget the red key, you need it to exit. Looks like everybody's dead on this floor. They're going down again. Oh, we went up. I'm dumb. See? This is what I mean. That's how you progress. The next floor was over here. I'm dumb. Don't do what I do. Don't be like me. Ooh, giblets. Get your rocket launcher. And you can just kill that cacodemon without anywhere. If you fall down in here, you can just hang on to this ledge. It does go down. Alright, I'm going to grab my chain gun here and check all of the rooms. We're going to go the reverse direction this time. This revenant, though, needs to die. Come on, help me out there, buddy. Welcome to the Master Levels, where chain gunners will help you kill revenants, because that also happened in Trapped on Titan. Or no, Titan Manor. Alright, everyone's dead on this floor. Now to get the last two secrets. This switch, when you press it, it does a thing. I know, I understand that's a hard concept to grasp, but it does this thing. So now you can press that switch. Run back around, come up here, grab the, Berserker fist, and just punch the fucking shit out of that bastard. Just punch his teeth in. Get your BFG ready again, and progress down one more floor. Just wait a moment, make sure everybody's dead. Now, I'm going to make one suggestion. Do not grab your rocket launcher in this next area. It will get you killed. Alright, so we're good. We're good. Okay. Just pick them off. This is the only way I ever suggest you use your rocket launcher. Make sure there's nobody in the floor. There you go. A couple BFG shots on a weak... you know, if I don't get killed by the Cacodemons first. Oh good, you came up to visit. Well, hi there. So we have all three keys. You want to make sure everybody's dead. Somebody just spawned in up top. I don't even know what that switch does, to be completely honest. Somebody, I'm sure in the comments, will tell me. Alright, we got our supercharge. I think I know what it does. I think it lowers some of the other areas. Where are you at? Oh, and again, like I said, because a specific wall is bugged here. Right? There, make sure that the enemy dies. Or you can stand up here and just fire from there. I feel like there's an imp somewhere and he's missing. So now we'll go back through the eastern quadrant. With our, oh dear, our rockets equipped. Save three for that guy. Or, you know, just get in their face like me. It's okay. Try not to fall in the poison. That's advisable. There is a reason, though, that you're going to... I will explain that in a moment. Alright, they're dead. So this is why I said you don't even want to worry about the southern section. Because you're going to come back here anyway. Now, there's one guy. And I suggest having a BFG shot ready for him. Because he's in the poison, and there are no rad suits in this map. The only way in or out of the Black Tower at this point is through this door. And we are going to check one more time, and we're going to make sure that everybody is dead. I'm going to go up a couple floors and back down a couple floors, and then we're going to exit. God, I'm stupid! That's not even the right one. Because that imp has me wondering where in the hell he went to. Although, to be fair, this is the kind of map that it's not a bad idea to go back through one more time and just make sure you have provisions. Especially if you are playing them all, like, non-stop. Looks like everybody's dead. We're going back down. I believe we're finally done. I swear, if it doesn't say 100% kills, I'm going to, like, destroy an orphanage or something. Like, I mean, nobody wants those kids, right? I mean, that's why it's an orphanage. I'm gonna drop down. Looks like everything is dead. Alright, we're gonna leave. Oh my god, is it finally over? Is the nightmare finally done? Oh, right, these guys. You know what? Fuck your faces. One, two, and three. By the way, one switch here lowers this supercharge, so you know, you have it. Oh! Oh my god, it's over!
Oh! Oh my god!
Okay, so the entire map idea is fucking cool. Like, having a night, you know, having a multi-tiered level, you know, makes you feel like you have a sense of location. As you go further up, each floor is different. Each floor has its own cool aspects and different traps and different ways of having to approach these floors. But the problem is that it's overshadowed by a couple of really bad design choices. The first floor, with all the Cacodemons in the windows, fuck that. There are ways that you could have designed those windows a lot better. I'm sorry. Maybe not back in like 96 when people were still trying to figure, or 94 or whatever, when people were still trying to figure out how to do maps, you know, how to make maps easier and stuff like that. But, my god, those windows are the worst thing in this map, by far. I mean, like, it's so easy to miss a Cacodemon there and to never be able to kill said Cacodemon. It's that easy to just... And where in the hell do I have 100% kill, 101% kills from? Oh, right, Archvile resurrected something, I'm sure. But the fact that he resurrected something means that I probably have 100% kills, because, I mean, almost 400 enemies in this map. Come on. He'd have had to resurrect it like one, two things for me to, you know. Oh, right, it's the one in that fucking area. Never mind. Yeah, so he did resurrect quite a number. Anyway. Then there's the issue with the enemies that fall through the one step. It didn't happen in this run, but it has happened. I don't know if Doom Guy is possible, like, to fall through the floor. I've heard that you can and that you get stuck and that's GG. But in this case, I didn't have it happen. I've never seen him fall through the floor, but I'm not going to discredit that that's a possibility of something that can happen. Like, the map is great. It plays fine. It's just those two bugs, to me, are so critical. I mean, it's possible to get 100% kills, but the two Cacodemons, one in the western and one in the eastern window, they make this map so frustrating if you are a complete purist in trying to get everything. Yes, I did show the auto map, but I wanted to demonstrate the point that this is frustrating. The design on those windows is not the best. Like, if they had made the windows a little wider, if they had made sure that the Cacodemons all woke up, that would have been fantastic. But that doesn't happen here. It just doesn't. And it kind of takes a lot away from the feeling of this map, because you get frustrated. You're like, oh my god, why do these fucking enemies have to do this shit? And it's very tedious. Not to mention that this map is really fucking long. Really fucking long. I mean, I could have ended it like 2 minutes ago, but I went all the way to the back up to the top of the tower and came all the way back down. Just, I don't know. I don't know what else to add in. This map is hard as balls. Get ready, because it's hard as balls. But it's done. It's over. It's finished. I will see you guys in the next map. And I think you guys know exactly what's next, because we're down to the final two maps. So, with that, I'm Ultimate Mantoid, and this is Let's Play the Master Levels of Doom 2. Or Master Levels for Doom 2. I need to go look at that again. Anyways, take care and have fun.